Hey, guess where we are today? Ah! It begins with H. Hamilton! And guess what we're here to do? We are going to talk about... Yes! Chlamydia!
Yes, that's right, Mikey. Hamilton's got the pox and a river running through it. The Garden City's growing bacteria in the sweaty loins of young men and women who are having it off whilst drunk in the general vicinity of Hood Street. But not just Hood Street, Chartwell, Fairview, Hamilton East.
Where you are in Hamilton is the chlamydia capital of New Zealand.
The what?
Chlamydia.
What is that?
It's a sexually transmitted disease. How old are you?
17.
And you don't know what chlamydia is?
No.
Dimsdale, Hillcrest, five crossroads and all down road.
Tell us your story.
Well, I'm Shivani and I met my husband on the internet.
Have you either of you ever been tested for chlamydia?
For what?
Chlamydia.
What's that?
It's a sexually transmitted disease.
No. You guys are crazy, you know that, don't you?
You are.
Show me the way to San Jose. I want to know if my six bits are okay.
Do Hamiltonians root more than people in the rest of the country? Or are they dirtier?
They're not dirtier.
No.
Absolutely not. In terms of how much sex they have, we can't speculate. Specifically, it's been identified that there's a huge rate of chlamydia amongst young people in Hamilton, 15 to 24 year olds.
But they're just kids.
Sexually active kids.
What are the signs that we're looking for to know that we've got chlamydia?
Good question, because you're making the assumption that someone will actually have signs. So for men, 50% of them who have chlamydia will get discomfort when they pee. They may notice.
Describe that discomfort for us from your experience.
From my experience?
Well, you know, from the experience of patients. Because, you know, as we say, it's just an infection, it's discomfort when you pee. You know, it's sort of like saying, well, there's a stone in my shoe.
Pissing razor blades.
Have any of you guys been tested for sexually transmitted diseases? Ever?
No.
Ever?
He has.
No.
Never. What are the signs for girls?
Girls,
providing that there are some signs.
Girls are even less likely to get signs or symptoms. It can lead to chronic pelvic pain, infertility, or ectopic pregnancy. These days, to test for chlamydia, it's simply a case of...
These days, so any day as of from the moment that this program goes to air...
Absolutely.
We are...
Peeing in a pot.
Doing wheeze.
Yeah.
It's wheeze now.
It's wheeze.
I feel a whole lot more comfortable about being tested for chlamydia now.
So would you like to be tested?
Okay.
Do you want to do
No, I'm not.
No, you do it. Jane's on a roll.
You know, it's a common misconception that they stick a little steel umbrella down, well, but they don't do that anymore. It's an altogether much more comfortable process. Hey, news, keep your eyes off the prize.
And then we get you to wee.
Hardly felt a thing. Time to simply do wheeze into a jar. Please respect our privacy! So we've done the old with that and then into that, and but what about if we're a little bit worried about privacy? I mean, we're in the public eye, excuse the pun.
And do we have to put our real name?
No, you don't have to use your real name.
Good. For privacy.
Yes, it does. It's all confidential. Yes.
Okay, so I am. I don't want to be Newsboy, obviously.
Yeah.
Can I be Neil Martin?
Yeah, sure. You can be Neil Martin.
Sure.
As long as when you ring back with when you're asking for your results, that you give Neil Martin as your name. As long as you remember that name.
I should do.
Yeah.
Okay. And I'll be Chris Rankin.
Bye.
We've had a wonderful day at the Waikato Sexual Health Clinic. And you know, for a couple of guys who are legendary for taking the piss, today we've had the piss taken out of us, so to speak.
Cheers.
Cheers. Oh, I got yours.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's definitely yours.
Sorry, yeah. Yeah.
Don't let the sun set on your sex life. Get a checkup now.